I think most people would agree that what you achieve in life has a lot to do with what you primarily focus your time and energy on. So if you're not happy with your life, if you don't have enough money, or if you get up in the morning dreading going to work, it's time to ask yourself some tough questions. What is the primary focus of your life? Are you like most Americans that spend an average of 34 hours a week watching TV? Did you know that the most popular television show right now is Dancing with the Stars? Now, I can see maybe spending a few hours a week watching some mindless dribble or a football game, but 34 hours a week? Just think what you could accomplish with that amount of time. And the time wasting doesn't end with television. Right now, there's over 1.4 billion Facebook users in the world. On average, these users spend over 15 hours a month on Facebook. We all know people that spend a lot more time than that. How many of those hours do you think are productive? For many users, the vast majority of time spent on Facebook is spent putting up displays of pictures and gossip. So if you're into social networking in a major way, I would urge you to take a serious inventory of what all this activity on Facebook, Twitter, and other social networking sites is really accomplishing. Is it helping you achieve your main goals in life? Are all these activities getting you closer to financial independence? Are they propelling you towards a life in which you can't wait to get out of bed and engage in work or activities that bring you a deep level of pride and satisfaction? If not, it's time to create a time budget. Creating a time budget is very similar to making a budget regarding your finances. Time, like money, is very valuable. If you squander it, you get to the end of your life with lots of regrets and not very many options. Being aware of your big time wasters is half the battle. Now, I'm not saying that you should stop watching television altogether. Just keep in mind that there is a cost in lost time that can never be retrieved or bought back. You only have so much time in this world. Over a third of it is spent sleeping. For most of us, another third is spent working. That remaining third is all you have left for accomplishing your goals, loving your friends and family, and crossing things off your bucket list before you die. Knowing this, you have to ask yourself, is watching Dancing with the Stars, The Bachelorette, or America's Got Talent really worth it? Since over a third of our day is spent working, one way to really get the most out of the time that's allotted to you is to find work that you're passionate about. People that love their work are really fortunate. Pulling off this feat usually requires you to take deliberate steps to accomplishing this goal. For many, it will require that they ultimately become their own bosses. In doing so, they can shape their life so that it gives them maximum enjoyment and a deep sense of satisfaction. Now, I'm not saying that it's impossible to be happy unless you're self-employed. I'm just suggesting it's more difficult when you have less control of your work life. When you're your own boss, you can choose work that's centered around your interests and passions. You also have total control of where you live and work, when you work, and who you work with. Now, if you're like most of us, you probably don't have the financial resources to quit your job and launch a full-time pursuit of starting your own business. As a result, you will need to pursue your dream of self-employment more slowly until your new business has sufficiently strong legs to stand on its own. Initially, when you are in transition from being an employee to being totally self-employed, you will need to make sacrifices. Squandering your free time will not be an option. As a result, you must be prepared to fight your past tendencies to pop a beer and watch the game or fritter away the hours surfing the net with no real purpose in mind. You also have to accept that initially you will have to borrow time from other activities such as sleep or time with friends and family in order to accomplish your business goals. keep reminding yourself that ultimately the pendulum will swing back over to more family time and leisurely pursuits once you have a mature and stable business and you can quit your job. So how do you stay on track and budget your time wisely in order to successfully launch your new business? One of the most important things you need to do is define your business goals. They need to be concise and concrete. They need to be motivating. You need to be able to picture your future self actually living the reality that you're determined to create. Having goals is not enough. You need to define the necessary steps that need to be accomplished in order to bring them into fruition. This is done by describing the milestones required to accomplishing your ultimate goals. Having milestones will help you keep your focus laser sharp. Remember to celebrate accomplishing your milestones, since their achievement means you're getting that much closer to your ultimate goal. Writing down your business goals and milestones transforms them from, gee, wouldn't it be nice, to now I know what I want and what I need to do to make it happen. It takes it to a whole different level. In the business world, this is accomplished by writing your business plan. One very useful website that can help you carry out this important task is newbusinesscreator.com. This website will provide you with all of the essential information you will need to know to start and launch a new business. All this knowledge is offered in easily understandable videos and corresponding narratives. After writing your business plan, you will need to build your business team. Unlike most job listing sites, EmployerPro.com is geared towards finding skilled workers that are looking for opportunities in new businesses and startup companies. This site will also help you find freelancers that can help you accomplish short-term goals. For any company, raising business capital is a critical component for launching your new business venture. On NewFundingNewBusiness.com, you can also apply online for an SBA loan to help fund your new business idea. Alternatively, you can use NewBizCrowdfunding.com to raise capital using crowdfunding. If outside-the-box solutions are needed, you can turn to NewBusinessTrade.com to search for persons or companies that are willing to accept equity, royalties, or a percentage of future profits in return for raw materials, finished products, skilled workers, commercial space, or marketing. Once you're ready to sell your product or service, you can use New Business Creator's affiliate listing sites in order to find marketing solutions that will best suit your needs. NewBusinessMarket.com can help you find a product distributor or sales agents. If your goal is to sell your products or services using the franchise method, NewBusinessMarket.com can be used to market your franchise opportunity to potential franchisees. This website can also be used to find internet marketing solutions such as affiliate marketing, banner advertising, internet sales, and email marketing. WebTrailOffers.com is another marketing solution you may want to consider. This website caters to users who are actively searching for web promotions. Users of this site are motivated buyers, selecting from categories of products or services, entertainment options, and website content. In summary, it's time to focus on creating your new business. NewBusinessCreator.com can help you create and implement your business plan so it can be accomplished in as short a time as possible. The tools are all there. All that's required is for you to pick them up and use them.